Well, here I am, taking Dr. Al's advice and borrowing the Writing Center cubby hole to do a video. Okay, let me set the stage. Thursday, Dr. Al wasn't in class, she had a presentation, but we did an assignment about voice. And it was all about adopting another person's voice to express, to tell a story. And it was intended to stretch us and get us less comfortable and make us think about what voice sounds like, to recognize that individual characters, individual people have their own voices. So I basically sat around for 20, 30 minutes in class, and I had great ideas that I really liked, but none that I could actually picture myself writing. And I think that was kind of the point, but every time I tried to start, I just got overwhelmed. So I could just tell that they weren't right. They were cool ideas, but they weren't gonna work for that. So I finally came up with an idea in the last 10 minutes or so of class. I decided I wanted to do The Fall of the House of Usher, which has a lot of significance for me as a reader and as a teacher and everything. But I didn't, and so I wanted to do The Fall of the House of Usher, and I wanted to do it in a different voice. And I thought it would be really cool to see, I don't know what I thought. I thought it would be cool to do multiple voices, if I could find a way to do that, which kind of stemmed from my desire to do the 12 Dancing Princesses. I wanted to do something in a group. Fall of House of Usher doesn't have many characters, has 3. But I realized that something that would be fun would be Magic School Bus. Who doesn't like the Magic School Bus? I love the Magic School Bus. I had also just quoted Miss Frizz earlier that day, so I think that kind of led into it. So, I did the Magic School Bus, and not just doing Magic School Bus, I did Inner City Magic School Bus to change up the voice a little bit. So what we have here is Inner City Magic School Bus and The Fall of the House of Usher. I don't think there was an episode about that. I might have to change that. So my paper started out just a few paragraphs in my notebook. And I had a headache trying to keep straight who was who and everything. So what happened was, I went home, I gave it a couple days, and then I sat down and typed up what I'd already written, and then I kept going. And the result of that is one of the longest papers I've ever written. Definitely one of the longest ones I've ever done without being required to do that many. It's an 8-page paper. Yeah. I usually have a hard time with a 5-page. Even when I was in a creative writing class and we had to do it, 8 pages was basically unheard of for me. I'm incredibly proud of myself. I feel like this kind of makes me a writer. And it's not just typical writing. I don't know what it is. It's something different for me. Usually I pick a genre and stick with it. But this time I started out 2 pages of a script, including the stage directions. And then I do a paragraph of a reflection, kind of. It's a character of the script, but it's what he's thinking about going on. So it's less dialogue and more of a typical paper. It's not just, not just dialogue, not just a script, but then it changes to typical description of the plot. That's what it was. But the description of the plot is still in the character's voice. So it's kind of what he's thinking. So that was pretty neat. I like it. Of course, this was also 3 a.m., so. And part of the reason that it happened, to be honest, is because I was getting tired and I could see how long this paper was going to be. I just saw a correction that I needed. So, I did script, and then description, and then script, and then description. And it was just so neat. I really liked it. And I renamed some of the characters. Like, instead of Roderick and the narrator Madeline, it's Sicko, Psycho, and Sad. And so it ends up, there's a lot of description of what's going on that you get in Arnold's voice, because Arnold's the fun one. And then there's, at the last page, they start talking about, they go back to a script, to a dialogue. And it's a turn. And then at the end, just like in the TV series, they would give you a hint of what's to come the next time. I left a little hint of what could come next, what would come logically from the fall of the House of Usher, which of course was the Titanic at 3 a.m. Really excited about this. I'm wondering what I could do. Here's what I'd really like to see happen with this. I would like to find the time and the energy and the skill to make little characters that would stick on a pencil and that could stick into styrofoam. And they would be the characters that I wrote. And I would let them act out the part. I could see this happening. I could see them, little, like, curly red hair on this one, or, but it would be really difficult being one person, because there's a lot that kind of goes on sometimes behind the scenes, or that's not being the character speaking. So, like, one character would be over here speaking, while these two over here are fighting, but I'd like to see how that would work. I think it could work. I would include the bus, of course. And the lizard. Actually, I have a different thing for the lizard. But I think all in all, this could be pretty interesting. Just picture this. Like, here's the house. The Kleenex box is the house. I don't know. I'm also on like 4 hours of sleep, so don't judge me. I'd like to see what could happen with this. I think, if anything, I could at least read it for a video log or post it on my blog. It would be something good to put there. But I think the most fun I would have with it is to act it out. It'd be even more fun if I could get people to actually act it out, but I think that's asking for a bit much. I would be willing to settle for little pencil people instead of full hopping around in their costumes. And I could change up my voice for each one. And I could sit, like, off here. So it would be just the characters, and I would just do my talking thing. Okay, kids, gather up. Today we're studying Poe. Who knows who Poe is? That when you don't have a lot of money. No, stupid. So when you give people water or something, you gotta be careful not to spill. How would you know? You spill everything. Don't know it. Take it back. And then we have a fight break out, and Frizz is breaking up the fight. And then there's Dorothy, and of course. Both of you are astronomically incorrect. Poe, or Edgar Allan Poe, was an American writer of the Romantic style who amused his audience with tales and poems of horror and suspense. Some of his best-known works are The Raven, Annabel Lee, The Cask of Amontillado, The Fall of the House of Usher, and The Telltale Heart. He was found dead in a gutter in Baltimore, supposedly after a night of drinking, much like Carlos's dad.
Hey, don't go bringing my daddy into this. You don't got no clue about my daddy. Miss Riz, is that true?
Certainly is, Carlos. And thank you, Dorothy, for that wonderful introduction into today's lesson. We'll be studying the 4th text DA mentioned, The Fall of the House of Usher. Pull out your textbooks, turn to page 346, and we'll begin. And it goes on from there. It was pretty fun to write, I gotta say. Which makes it one of my favorite texts to have written. I don't usually enjoy writing, but this was kind of fun. And I actually went back to it and I finished it instead of just putting it away out of fear that it would end up sucking. We'll see about later today.